Don't mind the drawing, because this is about the camera algorithm. This is an open source project that uses the olcPixel game engine. You can download everything in the links below. In terms of a 2D camera, what I think is important are two things, parallax and zoom. Now, everything in a video game happens inside a virtual world. This world doesn't really exist, it's there only on your RAM, or your imagination, or in ones and zeros. It can be as big as you want, or as small as you want. Why am I talking about this? Because there's another world which we call screen space. Screen space has physical limitations. You're bound by the number of pixels you have on your screen, or your game window. What we do is update individual objects inside our game world, and then we portray that onto our screen space. So if we have the player, a bunch of objects, and a camera in our world, we're only going to draw what's within the range of the camera, but of course the entire world is always there as data. We know there's no real camera inside our computer, there's only camera position and player position. The question is, how do we give an illusion that we're looking through a camera on our computer screen? Well, moving a 2D camera is easy. We give a relative position to every object in our scene. If you haven't watched my other videos on vector arithmetics, please make sure to watch them because it'll be the underlying concept for not only moving but also zooming and parallaxing. Anyways, let's say that we get a vector from the camera to every other object. We get the center of the screen, which is the center view of the camera, and use a relative position to place our objects. For example, if relative position of a box is 10:10, then we go exactly 10:10 from the center of the screen, and that's it. As we move our camera, our little equation is going to ensure that everything else moves accordingly. From the developer's perspective, we can now manipulate anything and everything inside our virtual world, but we still trust our system to portray the world to the screen in an accurate way. And the rest is easy. Zooming in and out just means that we're introducing multiplying to the equation. Again, make sure to watch my other videos on vectors. Let's look at our box again. It's 10:10 away from the camera. If we want to have 50% scale, or zoom out, we simply multiply by 0.5. So now the screen position in relation to the camera is 5:5. Let's also say that it's a square box with a width of 5. If you zoom out, or reduce scale by 50%, not only do you have a relative position of 5:5, you also have relative width of 2.5. And since we're portraying an entire world, we do the same thing to every object. The result is an illusion of a camera movement, as well as zooming in and out. This project takes one step further. I want the camera to always show the ground at the bottom. The problem is that if you zoom out, your view gets larger, so ground level is higher on our screen. I want to move the camera in a way that even if we zoom in or out, the ground level stays the same on our screen. A solution is keeping the ground level based on a percentage. I want the camera's Y position to remain at about 35% of the screen height. This means that if we zoom out, we're getting more view, but the camera position is also going higher to keep the ground level near the bottom of our screen. One thing to keep in mind is that we're updating things in the world position, so we need to convert the position based on our screen to our virtual world. This is simple if you understand vectors, because all we're doing is multiplying. In this case, we're going the other way, so we're dividing, but multiplying and dividing work the same way. So here's my single line of code that converts screen space Y position to world space Y position. I would also recommend watching this video by one lone coder. It's the same concept, expressed in a different way for a different purpose. Don't get caught up with the syntax, try to understand the idea. Let's move on to parallaxing, which gives you the feeling of depth. We're just going to build on top of the camera system. All we're doing is placing objects based on a percentage to the camera position. Let's say the sun, which is the farthest away, has 90% position of the camera. The mountains and the clouds, which are the next farthest objects, have 80% position of the camera. The trees, which are the closest, other than the players, have 65% position of the camera. Now, if we move the camera, the objects are going to follow, except each of them follows according to a different percentage. And then the players are not affected by the camera position at all. This gives you the feeling of layers based on the arbitrary distance. I like that the sun is slightly behind the clouds, and depending on the camera angle, things sort of slide accordingly. I probably should have placed the clouds on a separate layer compared to the mountains, but this is a rough draft. I hope you understand the mechanics. I'm now free to update the players however I want to, without worrying about the camera or the background, and vice versa. I can update the camera in world space without worrying about what the players are doing at any given time. In summary, the virtual world exists in our data. and our screen is just a window for you to see into that world. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, you can reach me on my Discord server. I have all the links below. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.